sun to go down.
Hmm? Oh, well, why do birthdays take so long to arrive, but appointments at the dentist come too fast? Hmm?
It's the mystery of time.
But why can't we eat the Passover meal now? Why do we have to wait until sunset?
We wait because this night is different from every other night for all the Jewish people. When I was 8, I too waited for the sun to go down. It was the middle of the Second World War, and the Nazis had sent millions of Jews into concentration camps. Those of us who hadn't been murdered were dying of hunger. The place...
Outside! All of you!
...where I celebrated the Passover meal at your age was called Auschwitz.
How could such things happen?
I have many answers for your questions, but no answer for that one. All I know is there has been evil in the world for a long time, and there has been good. Thousands of years ago, the Jewish people were known as Hebrews or Israelites, and they had been slaves in Egypt for generations.
I see these Hebrew slaves stretching to the horizon.
Thousands of Hebrew warriors. They will rise up and destroy my kingdom.
The Pharaoh ordered all the boy children to be thrown into the River Nile. But one mother fooled the Egyptians.
Moses?
Yes, Moses. He was found by the Pharaoh's daughter. She brought him up in the palace, and he watched his own people suffer.
Why are you torturing my people?
Your people?
I am a Hebrew. I will always be a Hebrew.
I obey the king of Egypt. I don't listen to Hebrews.
But Moses couldn't stay in Egypt. He knew that soon Pharaoh and the soldiers would be after him. Moses waited in the wilderness for years.
I hate waiting.
You think Moses didn't? He waited till he was 80 years old. Sometimes it takes a long time for a person to learn how to listen to God.
Moses, I am the God of your fathers, and I have seen the suffering of my people. I will free them. I will guide them into a new land.
Freedom for my people, but...
I have chosen you to be their leader.
Me? But they will say, who sent you to us?
I am who I am. Say this to the people of Israel. I am has sent you.
The new Pharaoh was just as cruel. He would not let the Israelites go. So, God sent terrible plagues against Pharaoh. But still, Pharaoh refused to obey him. Last of all, God sent his angel of death. That was when Moses told the people to prepare a meal and paint a sign on every door so the angel of death would pass over. The first Passover meal. Judgment fell on the evil of Pharaoh. Even his own son fell sick and died. Then he let the people go. Every time you eat this meal, you are there with the children of Israel.
Escaping into the desert.
You see this bowl of salt water? Hmm? Where we dip our herbs and eggs at Passover? This is like the tears of all the Israelites. For soon, Pharaoh changed his mind and chased after them.
Why have you brought us into the desert to die?
There's no hope.
Don't be afraid. Stand still.
Stand still?
God will fight for you. Don't move. Just watch.
For the first few months in that desert, people did nothing but complain.
There's no food here.
What shall we say to the people? Go and fill your stomachs with sand?
I will send bread from heaven. Then the people will know that I am their God.
How lovely! Food from the sky. What is it?
It's sweet, like honey.
Oh, is that how it really was? Bread falling from the sky?
Who knows? It appeared on the ground like frost. They called it manna from heaven.
So after that, the people were happy forever.
Happy forever? Are you joking?
Water!
We need water. Give us water.
Where is this God?
Why should I lead these ungrateful people to freedom?
Moses, Moses, I will stand beside you at the rock of Horeb. Take your staff and strike the rock. Before all the people, there will be streams of water flowing in the desert.
Behold the power and the everlasting love of the Lord your God.
The Israelites had to be patient, wait for God.
Waiting's hard, especially when you're hungry or thirsty. Some things just take forever.
Forever is short compared to how it seemed when Moses disappeared.
Disappeared?
Now we have no leader. No God.
We must wait. We've got to trust him.
So where is this great God of Moses?
We don't even know where Moses is.
2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month. No one saw or heard from Moses because he was walking alone with God, gazing on the holy commandments, which God himself was writing in stone.
Moses is dead. Let's find a new leader.
Leader? Let's find a new God.
Don't you fear the anger of the God of Israel, the one who led us out of Egypt?
Aaron, you make us a God. A God we can all see.
Perhaps they're right. My brother Moses is dead.
Aaron, no! No! Believe!
You want a new god?
Yes.
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 Give me your jewelry. Your earrings. Give me all your gold.
They put their faith in a lump of gold.
Oh God, come down. Save us.
What is this?
It's Moses. Moses. He's brought back from the dead.
Other gods before me. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Honor your father and mother. You shall not kill.
Grandpa, that was your fault.
So I got a little carried away. You know, it's nice under here.
It's like a house.
Like the tent Moses built for God.
Tent? What exactly happened in the tent, Grandpa?
What happened? Everything happened because this was the place that God had chosen to be his house on earth. Here, all the people could learn the laws of how to live, all the ways of the Jewish people.
Written down in the Torah?
Yes, the Torah. It's the way to freedom in our hearts. He followed God for many years. And before he died, Moses was allowed one great, magnificent view of the Promised Land. For hundreds of years, there have been Passover meals all over the world. Jewish children have waited for the sun to go down and for this story to be told. And now it is your turn to tell the same story as I have told it to you.
This is one journey we all must make alone, Mardana.
At least I'll be here to bury your body.
Hey, my father was born a Hindu. We cremate the body.
Look, tonight you Muslims lay flowers on my left side, Hindus on the right. Whichever flowers remain fresh in the morning, they will tell you what is to be done.
He died in that inky blackness just before dawn, when the air is like nectar. He was born at that hour as well. I grew up in the same village as Anak, so I often heard tell how the stars sang at her birth. Maybe that was why Nanak loved to sing. God's light in his eyes. And
So could his sister, Nanaki. But not everyone.
Do you want to be late on your first day?
Can't I go to school, Papa?
You're a girl.
Hi. So can I go?
You're a Muslim, Madlana. This is a school for Hindu boys. Nanak! Stop! They are untouchables.
I only want to learn about God.
Nanak!
Let Nanak teach us.
On the paper of faith, with the pen of your heart, write the thoughts God inspires you to think. You write what I tell you to write. Out!
Nanak! Doing nothing again.
I'm trying to understand God.
We are Hindus. Many gods show us the way.
No, only one. He, the God, is not male or female.
Empty words. Now I have a word for you. Work!
Papa!
Shh! You can look after my cows.
Nanak loved his work, even when he grew up. It allowed him to think about God, which he never stopped doing, just as he never stopped driving his father crazy.
Nanak!
Father, I was thinking, all the things we do wrong, God forgives us.
It better, because I won't. You have let my cows ruin a poor man's crop.
How will I feed my children or pay my rent, sir?
You lazy, worthless boy!
It's a miracle.
Kalu, Nanak has been touched by God.
Ha!
Why has God done my work? Because he wants me to do his? Nanak, heaven is calling me.
What kind of God would ask you to leave your wife, your two babies?
A God who says we should not put our own needs at the center of our lives.
How do you know what God says?
I look into my heart, Sulakni.
Don't go. With you, I feel like I'm queen of the whole world.
I will think of you every day. Every day you shall be queen.
I went there. Well, how could he make his hymn without me to make the music? We went first to his sister Nanaki in Sultanpur. Her husband, is a storekeeper. But he gave away food to the poor.
Oh, no.
Thank you.
With God's help.
This must be what God chose you for.
Is it?
Nanak thought about God all the time. In the morning, in the inky blackness just before dawn, he would go to the river to pray.
It is time for you to begin the work for which you were born. Go now. Spread love. Glorify my name. Destroy hypocrisy.
Nanaki, it's been 3 days.
He can't be dead.
Be merciful as I am merciful. My name is God, and you are my divine guru. God is neither Hindu nor Muslim. So whose path shall I follow? I shall follow God's path.
So now it follows God's path. From India to Arabia to Persia.
Truth above all. Above truth. Truthful conduct. If you do something, do it well. Do not cheat. Do not lie.
When I heard there was a holy man in town, I had my servants prepare a feast.
Will you share my bread? Did you earn your bread by honest work? Yes.
Eat my food, Guru.
Your bread is earned by the blood of those who do your work for you. He who eats what he earns by hard work and gives with his own hand, he alone knows the true way of life. You know, you can't take your money with you, but you can take your good deeds. Feed the hungry. Clothe the naked. House the poor.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. Go on.
Thank you.
He's an untouchable. Now you will have to purify yourself.
Because I touched her? God made her, and God's spark is in her.
We were the only people traveling from nation to nation. The armies of the powerful Emperor Baba were advancing to the
This king is a butcher. Cruelty is his knife. Mercy is his heart. A lion falling upon helpless children. All this slaughter, this weeping, does it not move you? You do not fight fair, Emperor. God has seen what you have done here today.
Have mercy on me, man of God.
Then show mercy.
The emperor did. He set free 1,000 prisoners that day.
Mardana, why has God set me free?
So that you can go on spreading his word.
Actions speak louder than words. I have told the world how to live. Now I must show them.
So, Nanak created a village, a place in which everyone's bread brought forth milk, not blood. And he called it Kartarpur, creator of stuff. And when the fields were growing with the first harvest, he brought our families to Kartarpur.
At last.
Where shall we sit?
Here.
Here? I'm their guru's father.
We are all children of the same father. Man or woman, rich or poor, Hindu or Muslim.
What do you think?
This place is like the ocean.
Ocean?
The fish does not understand how great the sea is. But without it, he will die. The people here do not understand how great God is.
But without him, they would die.
Wonderful words, Tripta.
Your son's words.
I think I have been a fool. Nanak also said, the things we do wrong, God forgives us. I hope he's right. Of course he is right. He is the guru. I'm the old fool.
The time came for Nanak and me to grow old. Nanak had been chosen to teach his truth. Now God chose again. Lala, the God's guru, would speak God's words when Nanak died. He died in that inky blackness just before dawn, when the air is like nectar. We laid the flowers, just as he had told us to, Muslims on the left, Hindus on the right. When dawn broke, every bloom was as fresh as if it had just been picked. But Nanak was not there. What fools we were. Hadn't Nanak told us long ago, there is no Hindu, no Muslim, only God's path laid out before us, waiting for us to tread it, carrying us home.
God, the compassionate, the merciful.
I can tell you exactly what happened. It was my job to record the words given to Muhammad, peace be upon him, and to observe what he did. Down there, that's where he lived. The city of Mecca. It was a terrible place in those days. Not safe for man or woman or child.
It was a frightening place. But it all changed. I lived in Muhammad's house, and I saw for myself what he did.
It all began here, in this cave. He'd come up here when he wanted peace, time to think. Ever since he talked about that night, I've tried to imagine it. He was alone, praying, here somewhere in the darkness. Then he heard the voice of the angel Gabriel, commanding him to recite. I cannot recite, Muhammad said. The angel took hold of him and said, recite after me. But Muhammad could not. Recite, said the angel. Recite in the name of God who creates mankind, who teaches with the pen, who teaches mankind what they do not know. And Muhammad recited the words that the angel had taught him. Afterwards, he said, it was as though the words were written on his heart.
He came rushing home, came in shaking and sweating. He was afraid that he was possessed by a strange spirit.
He soon realized that it was truly the word of God filling his heart, and he had to take those words
and give them to the world. The holy place, the Kaaba. It had been surrounded by hundreds of idols, false gods. The whole place was rotten, noisy, drunken, dangerous. Men were cheated, women abused, children were treated like animals.
It was like the world had lost its way. God was telling Muhammad to put things right.
He inspired us. His honesty, his love, his goodness. He had learned the words of God and he taught them to us. I wrote down every word. You can read it for yourself. The Quran, our holy book. It was very hard in those early days. Once we came out in the open, life was dangerous. We had stones thrown at us. We were beaten up. Muhammad himself, peace be upon him, had animals' guts thrown over him while he was praying. Another time, he was nearly murdered.
And all because we believed in one God and spoke out against the idols. I remember seeing Abu Bakr, Muhammad's friend. His face, it was so smashed up, blood everywhere. And people were tortured.
People were dying, you know. Dying because of what they believed. Once I saw, they melted iron in a great pot and poured the molten iron over a man. Just because he was a Muslim, I was lucky. I survived. They tied me down on the burning sand. All I could see was the sun, and they piled rocks on me, huge rocks, crashing down on my chest. And they left me there, hour after hour. Many times this happened to me, but I would recite the Quran, and that gave me strength.
In the end, we were on our own. We had to live in a ghetto outside the city walls. No one could do business with us or give us food or water. But some people took pity on us. At night, sometimes they would send a camel with food and drink. A camel in secret, alone in the dark. People wanted to help us, but they were too frightened to do it openly.
God told Muhammad that we should leave Mecca. Many Muslims went to Medina, a city several days' journey to the north.
There were very few of us left in Mecca. Muhammad, of course, and Abu Bakr, some other women, and myself. We were still in the house the night the enemy closed in.
He's in the house. We've been watching. You are all prepared.
They waited outside the house all night. But God hid Muhammad from their sight, and he and Abu Bakr escaped from Mecca.
Follow them. They'll have gone north. That's where all the Muslims have gone. Quickly! Yalla, Emshi!
Muhammad was no fool. He headed south, not north. And he told me to follow his camel with my herd of sheep. Made his tracks harder to follow, you see. But the others, they were not fools either. They were after him pretty quickly.
That way!
The cave of Thor. That's where they'll be.
Thank you.
No one has been in there for days.
So Muhammad's enemies were fooled. God had spun his protection over Muhammad, and on he went to Medina.
We were only boys then, but we'd heard so much about him. Everyone wanted Muhammad to come and live near them.
So Muhammad said he would let his camel, Kaswa, choose. Wherever Kaswa stopped, that's where Muhammad would make his home.
The camel stopped at our guardian's house, and it was on our land that Muhammad later built his mosque. We wanted to give the land to Muhammad,
but he made us take money.
The honor would have been enough to give something, to be a helper to Muhammad.
Muhammad led us in building the first mosque. He worked with us, shoulder to shoulder, stone by stone. He taught us to live according to the way of God, to treat all people fairly. We learned to wash ourselves before prayer, to fast in the month of Ramadan.
When the mosque was ready, it was time for us to summon people to prayer.
I was so proud to call the people.
I'd go up near the mosque and call the people to worship.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah.
The peace couldn't last, of course. Muhammad's work wouldn't be done until the idols had fallen and Mecca was a city of Islam. And in the end, we had to fight. There was a caravan of camels traveling near Mecca, loaded with gold and spices. The people in Mecca said we were planning to ambush the caravan. It was just an excuse to attack us. We had 300 men against 1,000. But we had God. Our armor was in our hearts, not on our bodies. That first battle, we won. But a year later, we suffered a defeat. Muhammad himself was wounded. He'd have been killed if Abu Dujana hadn't shielded him with his body. This battle taught us many things.
I helped to bury the dead, men I'd known for many years. They died for God and they were blessed by him.
The third and final battle came. The Meccan army had cut us off. We'd been surrounded for a month. But God sent a great storm that overturned their fires, smashed down their tents, and drove them off into the night. We had beaten the Meccan army. But we had another 4 years of struggle before Muhammad led us into Mecca. Muhammad's dream had come true. He was back in the holy place, the Kaaba, and the day of the idols was over. There was much more work to be done, the word of Allah to be spread all through Arabia and far beyond that. And not long before he died, Muhammad made a speech on the plain of Arafat. Thousands of people came to hear him. He said, "Listen to me, O people, for I do not know whether I shall speak to you again. Do not hurt anyone, as you would wish others not to hurt you. Look after the poor and give them the clothes from your own backs. You men, you must treat women well, for they are your helpers.
I leave behind me two things. The Quran and what I have shown you by my example. If you follow these guides, you will not fail. Have I faithfully delivered God's message to you? He had done all that God had wanted him to do. Soon after that, he died.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
The greatest man in the world was dead. The man who had led me to God. There was great sadness. But we knew Muhammad was only a messenger. We had the Quran. Muhammad was dead, but Allah is alive. For Allah can never die.
Decided that in order to tackle Ravana, he would have to be born as a man. His wife Lakshmi became a woman, and some of the other gods became animals to help in any way they could. Hanuman the monkey, Jambavan the bear, Sampati the eagle, and his younger brother Jatayu also made their way to Earth. Lived a king with three wives but no children. He prayed to Vishnu for a child, and his prayer was answered. The years passed. Ravana's demons were still tormenting the holy man. Eventually, one of them begged the king to allow Rama and his brother Lakshmana, who were now both skillful bowmen,
beware, Rama, Lakshmana. I will return.
You have rid us of our darkness. Your reward shall be twofold. First, learn these holy mantras. Then, in your direst need, able to call upon the divine weapon. Next, I will take you to the court of King Janaka, where he who can sting the great boar Shiva shall win the hand of the king.
The mightiest warriors and the richest princes tried but failed to lift the bend of the enormous boar. But Sita only had eyes for Rama, and at last it was his turn. Could hardly lift,
Rama had the strength to snap. With great rejoicing, Rama and Sita were betrothed, and all King Dashrata made plans for Rama to become king of Ayodhya.
But their joy did not last long. Jealousy sprang up among the wives of Dashrata. Rama was sent away. Sita and Lakshmana refused to leave him. Old Dashrata died of grief. Against his will, Bharata, another of Rama's brothers, was made king. So, as a protest, he placed Rama's sandals on the throne to await the return of the rightful king. Out in the forest, Rama, Sita, and the faithful Lakshmana began a new life. But there were still demons in the forest, including Ravana's sister, who desired Rama for herself.
Most handsome, sir. Marry me, and I will make you happy forevermore.
Alas, most lovely maiden, I am married already. But you could ask Lakshmana.
I am only his servant. You would not wish to marry me.
He dared do this to my sister. He shall pay dearly for his impudence.
Sita, you say, is beautiful. Assist me in capturing her. I will help you and avenge the death of my mother.
Oh, Rama, Lakshmana, look! The most beautiful deer I have ever seen. Please, catch it for me.
I don't know, Jesse. It may be a trick.
Surely, Rama. You won't refuse me my dearest wish?
But the demon did one last trick.
Help me, Lakshmana! Help me!
That was Rama's voice. He needs your help. Go to him, quickly.
Do not leave the circle. May the gods protect you. I will find Rama.
May I beg a cup of water from you, good lady?
Of course, sir.
I can go no further. Could you bring it to me here?
I cannot, sir.
Then I will struggle on to one who knows her sacred duty to those in my position.
Please. Forgive me.
Chatayo. Ramana has captured Princess Sita. I tried to stop
you. As the monsoon set in, Rama and Lakshmana began their search for Sita. One day, sheltering in a cave, they met a monkey.
I am Hanuman. I will help your search.
Thank you, Hanuman. If you find Sita, please give her this ring.
I will take some friends and return in a month's time.
We can go no further. We shall have to return and report our failure. It seems that Vajratayu died in vain.
Excuse me. Did I hear you mention Jatayu? He was my brother. I did not know what had happened to him. My name is Sampati. As you can see, I can't fly much now. But I still have keen eyes and ears. I saw Ravana carrying a lady in his flying chariot across the sea to Lanka.
To Lanka? So we are on the trail after all. Your brother has not died in vain, Sampati.
But what good does it do us? How can we cross the sea?
Hanuman knew how. He puffed himself up and flew off to rescue Sita.
If only you would become Lord Ravana's boy, it would be so much more pleasant for you.
Say you will!
No!
Will you return with me to Lord Rama?
Thank you for finding me. But Rama must defeat Ravana before I can be free. Please, give these to Rama.
But suddenly, Ravana's cruel son, Indrajit, appeared.
Oh, no. Amusing yourself with a monkey, huh? I think we ought to be allowed to share your pleasure.
To keep the Lady Sita here against her will. Release her immediately.
You dare to tell me, Lord Ravana, King of Demons, what I should do? Bind the Firefly to his tail and let him dance.
Hanumando turned the tables on Ravana. He puffed himself up again and spread fire all around the city. But the God of Fire kept Sita safe.
Most valiant and clever Hanuman, you have set us on the path to victory. Forward to Lanka! Great father of the sea, show me how my army may cross to Lanka. Of course, a causeway. We need stones, branches, anything you can carry.
In this way, Rama's army built a road across the sea to Lanka. There they met Ravana's mighty army.
Once again.
But Ravana was furious that his son had been killed. He summoned his chariot and sped off in search of him.
Remember the divine weapon!
Ravana, for the very last time, will you surrender and release my wife?
Rama, you above all, know I cannot. Do what you must. I embrace my fate.
I have released you from the power of Ravana. Because you have dwelt under his roof, my people would not think it right that you should again become my queen.
Lakshmana, faithful friend, please make for me a circle of fire. The gods know that I have remained faithful to my husband, Lord Rama.
if I am pure. Oh, fire, protect me.
I knew well that the Lady Sita is brave and faithful. Now, all the world knows.
That is why we light our lamps at this festival of Diwali, to celebrate the homecoming of Rama and Sita, the conquest of the dark night.
This is now your mother. Mother. This is your son. It is finished.
Thomas.
Leave me.
Come with us.
Come back to the house. We'll be safe there.
There's no safety worth having.
Have I been fooled?
No, Thomas.
Against all reason, because of him, I learned to trust. I dared to love. Now there is nothing but nothing.
The past is as important as the present, Thomas. You must remember and believe.
God is dead. I believe what I have seen.
Then believe all that you have seen.
Believe what you saw here.
The pool of Bethesda, where the sick come hugging their filthy sores.
Remember then, Jesus came here one Sabbath morning.
Look at them. Blind, lame, paralyzed.
Oh, Father.
They're waiting for the waters to stir.
When they do, the first one into the pool will be healed.
So they say.
Ah, here he is.
Jesus.
Write down everything he says.
Do you want to be healed?
Listen, mate. I've been here for more than 30 years, right? I can't move my legs. The waters are stirred up. Everyone tramples across me and gets in first. What am I supposed to do, eh?
Stand up and walk.
Now listen, you! My legs!
You can pick up your mat and walk away. Now, begin to live.
Walking! Look! Walking! This Jesus is more dangerous than I thought.
Yes. Healing on the Sabbath.
He can stir up the people. That's what troubles me.
You follow him.
I'm walking! Look! Walking!
I do nothing of my own accord, but I obey my Father in heaven, who has sent me.
Father in heaven? Well.
My Father in heaven.
Yes, that's what they wanted to hear. His claim to be the Son of God. For that, they could kill him.
But if he was the Son of God, he would not have died.
You struggled for your belief, Thomas. Struggle to keep it.
There are people everywhere. I can't make out any faces.
I told you, they'll have been arrested.
We'll be next.
Listen, there's someone on the stairs.
Romans! Mary, no!
It's them. I know.
What happened? Were you followed?
We stopped at the Pool of Bethesda. We weren't followed. We're no threat to the Romans.
No. We are to the chief priests.
And they can apparently make the Romans do whatever they want.
They killed Jesus. Why should the rest of us be safe?
Eat something.
Try to forget.
One says forget, one says remember. We're spinning down a waterfall and you tell us to clutch at the air.
I can't believe he's dead.
You saw what we all saw.
Remember Lazarus? He was dead and is alive.
That was different.
But he gives us hope.
Maybe he'll return. Remember the story he told us?
There were dozens.
By the fire, at the lakeside.
I'll tell you the story of a farmer who had two sons. The younger son burned for adventure and excitement. So, he went to his father, and he asked for his share of the family fortune. With his pockets full of money, he traveled to a distant city. He was young, popular and rich, and there were plenty of things to spend his money on. And then one day, the money was all gone. Nothing left. At the same time, famine and poverty struck the city. So he took the only job he could find, looking after pigs. I'd be better off back at home, he thought. My father's farmhands live better than this. I might as well work with them. So sad and ashamed, he made his slow way home to where his elder brother was still working hard. But his father saw him coming. He couldn't believe his eyes. He called to his elder son, "Let the neighbors know and kill the fattest calf." But the elder son couldn't believe that his father would rush off to welcome a son who had wasted so much. I'm sorry, said the younger son. After what I've done, I dare not call you father. But he wouldn't listen to apologies. He thought his son had gone forever, and here he was again. That night, there was a great feast, but the elder son didn't feel like joining in. There had never been a feast for him. His father tried to explain. He's come home, and I thought he was dead. He was lost. Now he's found.
We must find a way to bury the Lord.
It's done already. Joseph's gone to Pilate.
Joseph? Who's Joseph?
Joseph of Arimathea.
You let a member of the council go to Pilate and ask for our leader?
Which one of us would have gone?
But to give the body of our Lord to the enemy?
We couldn't leave it for the kites and ravens.
Better than handing it over, as you've done.
Well, Joseph will be with Pilot by now.
True. A rebel's body is of no use to me.
Then I may take it.
You're a member of the Council. Aren't you satisfied with his death? Do you need the body too?
I did not vote for his death, but I dared not follow him openly.
Honest. Then tell me, Joseph of Arimathea, we're alone. Who was this man, really, that you forced me to kill?
He was the Messiah, the Son of God.
Go on, take your Messiah. The world has finished with him. Shut him away now.
You have done a good thing, Nicodemus. I feel like a criminal. This is not how it should have ended. You heard him teach?
Yes, nothing new, you could say. And yet no one had ever spoken like that before.
Love one another and make love your law. Everyone loves their friends. But I tell you to love those who are hard to love. Then the world may change. Mm. Which of you can grow an inch taller by worrying? Well, don't worry. Believe. Trust. Have faith. Your Father in heaven will look after you. Blessed are those who mourn and weep. They will be comforted. Blessed are the peacemakers. They shall be called the children of God. Blessed are the meek. They shall inherit the earth.
I will only listen to reason. I saw him die 4 days ago.
Yes, we all did. But he has come back, Thomas. He's alive again. I've seen him.
Lies are no comfort, Mary. We both loved him. Now admit the truth and let him go.
You won't let yourself believe.
I won't let myself be fooled. Until I see the marks of the nails, the spear mark in his side, I will not dare to believe.
Peace be with you, Thomas.
And peace be with you.
My Lord. And my God.
Thomas. Thomas. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. Make disciples of all nations. Teach them all I have taught you. And remember, I am with you to the ending of the world.
Thank you.
Bye.